Hey folks, I'm Daryl Cagle, and today's video is my coloring of the Republican Lemmings jumping off of the TrumpCare cliff. This is the cartoon that I drew yesterday afternoon, and today it needs to be colored, and it'll probably take me a little bit more than an hour, because that's just how long it takes me. Hello, DWC309, nice to see you here. This is my Wacom tablet. This is what I draw on. I've got a stylus. I draw like this. It's got a broken button on it, which is the mouse button on your mouse, but mine is broken, and actually I kind of like that. The Wacom people are very nice. They told me they'd send me a new one, but I kind of like it, but I'm broken because I don't like hitting the button by mistake, which I tend to do frequently. So this is what I'm working on today. Let us review for a moment. So here are Republican elephants as lemmings jumping off the cliff. Now, lemmings are a very common metaphor for editorial cartoonists. I've done them many times. This is a cartoon I drew when they had the revolution in Egypt, a lemmings cartoon that this is probably my favorite lemmings cartoon. I enjoyed this one. And this is probably my most popular Lemmings cartoon. This is the graduates graduating from college. This has been reprinted and plagiarized everywhere. This is one that I drew back in 2008 when we had the mortgage housing crisis, the George W. Bush economic collapse. I always kind of liked this one too. The goofier the Lemmings cartoon, the better. This is a Lemmings cartoon that I drew back, I guess this was late 2009, when Obama was pushing Obamacare through Congress. And so today's cartoon with the Republicans running off the cliff is much the same, except that the gag, I guess, is that it's TrumpCare, and then you see TrumpCare leads them all off the cliff. I guess I could have called it the American Healthcare Act. I could have called it Ryan Care, but Trump Care is more fun. So today it is Trump Care. And one thing I wanted to do was think about my other cliffs. So I kind of like the way this cliff is drawn. Kind of like the way this cliff is drawn. Not so happy with the way this cliff is drawn. Although, well, maybe that's effective, I don't know. Anyway, I give this new one more cliff details in the dirt and the rocks. And so I need to color that. I think probably the same like I did with the houses, kind of a... right. Well, let's do that. Okay, so I have line art here. And what I usually do when I start these off is I will save as, if you're looking at this on YouTube at darylcagle.com, there is also a video of my doing the line art for this yesterday that you can watch at 1.5 times speed. Which is very cool because that makes it 1.5 times as entertaining. Okay, the 400 dpi. Let's make it CMYK. All right. Now let's add 20 layers. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Ooh, I did 23 layers. I just want to fill the thing up with layers. Let's get the line art to the top. And we will select all, select color range. Okay, that's the black. Let's select the inverse and delete. And we'll select the black again. Make sure this is 100K. It is, and we will fill. Sometimes Photoshop doesn't like to fill with 100K. Fill. 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 All right. Now, is that really 100K? Let's check. Photoshop can be resistant. It is. It looks okay. All right. Now, in the bottom layer, I will fill it with white, which is 0000. Need to double check that because I have in the past had it do 1111 or something like that, and that looks like crap when it's printed, and I can't tell the difference on my monitor. All right, fill with white. Now this top layer needs to multiply that so that the colors show through underneath it. Now that I've done that, I can change my image size to 400. That should make it drop, make the window smaller. And there we go. Bump, bump, bump. Now when you look at these little details now, let's look at some details. Whew, not that much detail. Alright, so you look at these details in the cliff, in the guys, see they've got these little soft haze of gray lines that happen wherever I had the lighter black lines, and those are of course multiplying and printing on top, so I don't lose my lines that way, which is kind of nice. That's a reason for doing it at 1000 dpi to start with, so it lets you keep those little lines and gray them down when you go down to 400 dpi. So it should look just about as good as it does. If newspapers print it actually in CMYK, then the black lines will be nice and clean and crispy. And if they don't do it in CMYK, they print it in RGB, then all my efforts are for naught. Okay, I think that looks right. So let's save again. Remember, you folks can comment. I appreciate the comments. So, now when I did these guys, I did a kind of a blend in the background. That was kind of nice. Maybe I want them blending down into an orange because they're falling into hell. Well, if I do this, I'm going to need to have a solid color to do the blend. I kind of think I liked that blend. Yellow to blue was kind of nice. Well, let's think about it. That didn't work. Come on, label. B, C, K, G, D, B, L, E, N, D. Background blend. And let's call it blue. Well, do I want blue or do I want yellow going to orange? I think maybe I want yellow going to orange. Let's do that. So let's do I was going to make this TrumpCare arrow yellow in order to make it stand out, so I shouldn't do yellow back there, or that'll make the gag, which is the TrumpCare sign, not show up. So I should do blue. Let's just do blue. I'm going to do blue. Let's make it a little different blue. Let's make it 15 and 10. No, that's going to be... I'm going to make the elephants purple. Doctor of Common Sense. So do you think you're actually doing anything constructive and positive to the political climate, or do you think you're more so perpetuating a lot of negativity through your cartoons? I suppose those who disagree with me would think the latter. But of course, since I think the world would be a better place if everyone else agreed with me, I think I'm doing something constructive and positive. So the M is 0. Do I want it to be blue? I think I'm going to go with blue. Let's go with 20, like I did originally. And we'll do something big and soft. Ooh. That select all. All right. That's kind of dark. That's too dark. 16. I'm going to come in and lighten this up again with a little bit of texture. I like when little bits poke out beyond the background. That's kind of nice looking. Go into the grass, because I'm going to come back with grass color. Alright. Let's give it some sponge. The more negative, the better. Negative depends on your point of view, Doc. For half of America, I think most of my cartoons are positive. I should say, though, that most cartoons are not... maybe an exception lately, but most cartoons are not either liberal or conservative. They're about things like holidays, back to school. Oh, there was a big blizzard in the Northeast. Kids and their video games, those darn cell phones, you know. Think of most editorial cartoons most of the time, and they're not something you can classify as liberal or conservative. Give this a little bit of paper texture. That's something I wasn't doing back in the years when I did those previous Lemmings cartoons, which are all kind of old. All right, I've got a thicker sponge. Let's go with thicker sponge. Smaller. So I want to get the edges to be softer. So I need a different texture to soften the edges. There is something that we did to try to deal with all of the editors that have been calling us to complain about the cartoons being too anti-Trump. If you want to see what the newspapers see from us, go to kegelcartoons.com. That's our newspaper download site. And we have a new display there that is Trump-friendly cartoons. And I tell you, we've got to look through about 60 cartoons in order to find one that we can call Trump-friendly. I can see why the editors are all verklempt. Okay, that looks kind of nice, don't you think? The background blue? Blue is kind of calming and natural and maybe not appropriate for this cartoon. but I want the TrumpCare sign to pop. So let's do that first. We'll make that 100% yellow, because I really want that to read as part of the gag for the cartoon. So drop this back. I need it to be hard. There we go. Hey, if you're of a mindset to want to support Kaggle.com and see more editorial cartoons, don't let us drift softly into that good night, then we would appreciate your support. Kaggle.com/heroes to support Kaggle.com. We don't run ads on Kaggle.com. We depend on the generosity of strangers. Okay. Well, I think I should just block in the flesh tones for the elephant. So let's do that. Elephant flesh. Part of doing these videos is that I realize from talking to myself all of the mistakes I tend to make over and over. 26, 20, 15. That's kind of a good elephant color, 2015, good purple elephants. All right, let's do that. 1500%. All right. Hey! Doc, you followed. I appreciate it. I like the follows. See your zombie there. Hey, if any of you know a place where I can get other animations than that zombie, that would be fun. Give me a link. I'm not sure. I do that in Twitch alerts, and I think they've got a place where you can upload your own new follower animation, and that one's the default. So I would use some different ones. Using the default, I still do have a VCR that's flashing 12 o'clock for about 30 years. Bad to use the default. Although that zombie's kind of cute. DWC, I don't know. They just gave me one choice for an animation for a new subscriber. And so I took the one choice, and it was that cute little zombie. And I think you can have something different, but they don't offer it. You need to get it somewhere. And I would guess that other people on Twitch have other interesting little animations instead of just the zombie. Twitch alerts seems to be pretty popular. I like Twitch alerts. Most of you lurkers would be better about following. You could see more animations. It would be very exciting. I don't know the answer to that, DWC. If I was going to make it, I would think it would be an animated GIF because it's got that nice transparency behind it, and it doesn't look like it's a very big file. It's kind of a low res. So my guess would be animated GIF. I'm just blocking in a flat light purple for their flesh tone. Light purple because I noticed that in print, purple tends to gray down pretty significantly. Doc says, can you please do a cartoon about racist, stupid Trump supporters? You need to go look at my cartoons, Doc. So just blocking things in. They're going to have dark gray suits. You know, the cartoonists around the world have just been apoplectic in their anti-Trump cartoons. They use all the nastiest metaphors first. Nazis right out of the gate. But you never hear anything about Trump being angry with cartoons like the rest of the mainstream media he can't stand. I get lots of email from conservatives that think I'm part of the mainstream media and I take my orders from Hillary. Throw Nazi metaphors around, you diminish the real horror of the real Nazis. Trump is not a Nazi. He's got a Jewish daughter and son-in-law and grandkids. Trump isn't killing anybody, at least not yet until this healthcare law goes through. So I don't think drawing him as Nazi and KKK is a valuable cartoon. It just annoys the editors. Also the scatological stuff, the obscene cartoons. My goodness, more of those ever. More of those than we've ever gotten. Mostly from angry international cartoonists, more than the American cartoonists. So if you wonder why you look down at my head for all of this, it's because by looking down at my head, I can have the microphone right in front of my mouth, and you don't even see it, whereas you would if the camera was not quite so high. Here's the microphone, see? Hidden right behind the scroll bar. Microphone out of view because the camera is just a little bit high, looking down at me between my mouth and the microphone. So you think Mike saying Trump's not a Nazi is defending Trump, huh, Doc? You draw a pretty low bar. Okay. Let's give them some gray suits. I like for the gray suits to be have no K in them. And they'll come out a little bit blue. Let's put them here. Well, do I want them behind? Yeah, let's put them here. Suits. Ooh. That's on top of the flesh, isn't it? Let's put them down here. That way I don't have to worry about staying in the lines with the purple. Stream's not working well today. I'm sorry, DWC. That is a Twitch issue. If it just doesn't work for you, you can always watch it later on YouTube. Sorry about that. Happens sometimes. Twitch just doesn't want to keep up. Let's get the shoes too. Trick to doing shoes is make them just a little bit darker, the same color group. Which is true, DWC. We rather than saying we're against the world, I would say that we have nothing good to say. Anything positive is a lousy cartoon. That's why you're seeing all these Trump-bashing cartoons, even from the conservative cartoonists. And when they see something they like, they're just silent. They don't draw about that. So in the election, all the conservative cartoonists were not drawing Trump much. They were all bashing Hillary. And I get it. Supporting Trump cartoon is a stinking lousy cartoon. Supporting anything cartoon is a lousy cartoon. I sound like a Republican, Doc. Would a good liberal insist that Trump's a Nazi? Hey folks, all you lurkers, come follow me in Twitch and you'll get an announcement the next time I come on to stream. And if you're signed into Twitch, you can comment. And that gets me to keep talking. Otherwise, coloring in silence, kinda dull. I may come in and put a little bit of tone on top of some of these suits to give them a little bit of gray, brown, blue variety. Just a little bit. Maybe not. Kind of funny to have them all be the same. Maybe the same is better. Really, I'm offline? Well, that's interesting. Nope, it shows to me that I'm live, and it looks like the stream is okay, too. Maybe they just fixed it. Hey, Hey, Mad Games Live. Nice to see you here. Chat is working. Yeah, I see. I'm getting dropped frames. That's a Twitch problem. Oh, Mad Games Live. Thank you for the kind words. I think I need a follow from you. That's really the only way to find me when I come on to do this. Your desktop background. The Republican Lemmings has a desktop background. Easy enough. I think these Republicans are going to need some texture as well. So I'll come back on top of them, give them some texture. Hey, President Fox. Oh, President Fox signed up yesterday. One of you followed today. It looks like it's not showing up in my Twitch alerts. This cartoon is funny in that it has that big blank space in it. It's not something you typically see in a cartoon. All right, now what? How about white shirts and eyeballs? Always good to do the things first that you know what they need to do rather than having to figure something out. So I know I want white teeth and white eyeballs and white shirts. Might as well do that now. Oh, you've been following me. Phoebe sent you. Good, good. Phoebe is great. Let's erase this little bit on his tooth. Add some more white teeth. Oops. So I'm flipping my pen back and forth to use the eraser. Hey, DWC309, nice of you to follow. So give me some advice. Should I have them all wear the same color suit? I just blocked in a base color. I can make them different. But maybe having them all the same is funny. I think I needed this blue to make the TrumpCare sign pop. Otherwise, this cartoon would be too hard to figure out. You want different colors, huh, DWC? There's not a lot of variety in suit colors in Congress. They've got that one day of the year where they all wear a seersucker. But aside from that, business suit's pretty dull. Yeah, that's right, Mad Games Live. I thought we've got them all jumping off the same cliff, doing the same thing, with the same expression. So maybe wearing all the same suit and tie is funny. I like the red Trumpy tie. Problem with red is that it's kind of loud, and I don't really benefit from drawing attention to the ties with this gag. Aw, DWC, are you getting grouchy? Okay, I've got that. Okay, let's give them bottom of the shoe color. How's that for bottom of the shoe? That'll go on the one above the suits level. DWC, you've got somebody who's pretending to be you, who's on my screen. You come up as purple and he comes up as orange, so I guess he's a troll. Maybe he's that guy from yesterday. Bottom one? No. Well, I didn't get the whites of his eyes either. Guess that I'm 32. You're just trying to kiss up and make me feel good. Elephant flash. Let's take that back a little bit. Okay, so here's my overview. They're going to need some details in the suits and some light and dark in their flesh. Then 25. All right, then I will, let's do grass next. I know I need grass. 20, 0, 40. How's that for unobtrusive grass? Okay, let's do unobtrusive grass. Okay. Okay, there's the grass. You can have a little bit of green on these little leaves. A little bit of grass coming out of the cliff. Okay, and let's soften up the edge here a little bit. Make that, okay, 29, 120, all right. Softening up the grass edge here. Now let's bump it way up. That's the darker one, right? Alrighty. And we could have a little bit of shadow. That smaller and softer, and we'll have a little bit of shadow here. So we've got some stuff going on in the grass. Okay. All right, let's try cliff here. What's a good cliff color? I think I liked this cliff over here. Let's try that. I'll try a little bit of light, whatever that is. Looks like this. It's a little browner than that. Maybe that. All right. It's dark. Let's light it up a little. Make it a little bigger. And I'll soften this one up too. DWCS, can't you copy the color in Photoshop? I don't have those other images open in Photoshop. So, no. If I had opened all these images in Photoshop, yes, I could. Okay, let's come in and put in a little bit of detail here in the cliff. I think I'll put a little texture in here too, maybe a little bit of lights. Some extra dark, and I'll put those in just a few little spots. Oh, I'm sorry, stream is not good today. Do a little bit of detail. I can add some dark brown. Let's add some dark brown. 35%. All right, let's try it. That looks kind of nice. Add a little bit of whites. Maybe that is all I need for the cliff. Went out of the lines a little bit with this grass. Let's give it a little bit of tree color. Sorry, I guess I'm losing you folks with the lousy stream. Okay, I think that looks good for the cliff. Let's go back up to these guys. Oh, mad games. Are you having trouble with this getting dropped frames and running slow? I'm going to give them red ties. Let's do the red ties. Red ties are funny. Trump is kind of evolving in the way that editorial cartoonists draw him. Yeah, Mad Games, I am a syndicated editorial cartoonist. You can see my work at darylcagle.com, and I run a big editorial cartoonist site at, that's wrong, let's put it up here, at cagelcartoons.com. So go visit those, you'll see what I do. My work runs in about 850 subscribing papers, not including the Wall Street Journal and Forbes. Wall Street Journal has no editorial cartoonist, which is a shame. What city are you in, Mad Games? Funny when the stream stops. I was gonna say no, I'm wrong. Okay, let's do the clouds. Drawing on this for an hour and 5 minutes. Whoa, and I originally estimated this would take me an hour, and look, I'm running overtime. little bit of texture in them. Hey, Mad Games. No, I don't think it's on your end. I think it's on Twitch's end with the dropped frames today. Because I've got a good internet connection. And I've got my laptop open here next to me, where I can see what's going on the stream without slowing my computer down, because if I had that window open on my computer, a computer struggles to keep up. My little Mac. But I have it open on the laptop. And Chelsea, Quebec, 30 miles north of northeast Ottawa. Goodness. Sounds a little cold. Okay. This guy missed his white shirt. Let's give them a little bit of suit details. If I was being sloppy, I could have said I was done around now. Flesh details and suit details. Oh, forgot this guy's white eyes. 15 up. That's soft, that's hard. Okay. Too many things to forget. All right. Let's go with some suit details. Suit is where? Didn't I say where I was putting the suit? Suits. Okay. Wanted to grab the suit. Let's make it that much darker. Soften it up. Lighten it up. Now let's see what we can do with that. That's not bold enough, is it? DSL, my goodness. That sounds like 30 years ago. Oh, how did I do that? It's on this layer? Layer 4. Let's remember to fix that. I'm very impressed with the comic book people's organization, the way that they do their layers, and I am pretty disorganized. Yeah, long red tie on Trump, but I don't think regular Republicans have unusually long red ties. These are the congressmen. He needs his shoe repaired. There we go. All right, let's give them all just a little bit of goofy tone. Like good goofy tone. Let's put that here. And I will lighten it up. And let's give it a shot. Oh, that's too dark. That one. Look good on the bottom of the feet. What I find when this gets printed is that the sponge tone, which I made out of an actual sponge, tends to look like I did this as a on a piece of textured paper, which is kind of nice. And with paper, you don't have that much control over it. Paper is what paper is. All right, let's give them a little bit of white. No, I'm not sure. I'm not sure Trump is actually leading any of this. I don't think he even really cares much about the health care stuff, except that he promised and kind of stuck with it. This is the traditional GOP stuff. It's a big tax cut for the rich. You like your health care in Canada, Mad Games? That's often held up as the standard to match. Okay, they've all got a good deal of texture now. Let's take another look here. All right, do I like this? I might like it. Anything else to do on this, or am I done? I think I'm done. All right, now I also need to do a black and white version, so I'm going to save this one. And let's save as a grayscale. And I will take a look at what it looks like in grayscale. Usually I don't like these things in grayscale, but today it kind of doesn't look that bad in grayscale. Go to this background sponge and dark some things up a little bit. So I'll make that because when you do grayscale, you can deal with more more texture. I don't think I liked that. Let's lighten it up a little more. I don't think I liked that either. 1, 2, 3, 4. Maybe I'm just leave the background. Is it dark enough? Let's try this one. 17%. Might work a little better. And I think maybe I need to lighten their heads up a little bit. So let's do that. I didn't give them any tone on their flesh, but I'm not sure that they needed it. All right, that. And let's drop that back. Bump that up. When will it be on my website? I'm going to send it out to the newspapers as soon as I finish it. And it'll probably show up on Kaggle.com in my slot automatically when I post it to the newspapers. But it takes me a little while to process the videos for DarylKaggle.com and get this posted on my blog. So you'll see it first. You'll see it first in the newspaper flow. If you want to go to the newspaper site at kegglecartoons.com or politicalcartoons.com, the paper use site. All right, for black and white, I think perhaps we are. Oh, TrumpCare. Get in on that. That's grayed down, and it should not be grayed down. Oh, 100%. I want this sign to pop, and if it's got a light gray in it because it wanted to call the yellow light gray, then in black and white I need to come back and lighten it out to be 100% white for it to pop against all this gray stuff that's going on around it. Iconoclast. Nice to see you here. Ooh. Okay. Perhaps this is done. Let's look at this guy's teeth. Is that bothering me? Well, it's a little better, huh? Got the gardeners out there blowing and mowing. I don't know if you can hear that. I think this microphone does pretty well of only playing the sound a couple inches away. All right. Grayscale. So there we go. That is the grayscale. And this is the color. So you get to see it one way or the other. Here is the color and here is the grayscale. And I think we're done. So that is today's cartoon. Thank you very much, folks, for joining me. This will mark the end of our video. So, hey, if you want to see more of my cartoons, go to darylcagle.com. You'll see my oldies and my comments on things and the videos when I do videos I post with the cartoons. Go to kagle.com if you want to see the top cartoons from all the top cartoonists around the world. That's a wonderful site. We appreciate your help and support since we don't run ads on the site. And the site is very expensive to host since despots around the world don't like editorial cartoons and they send lots of hacker attacks around our way. It's a very expensive site to host. So we're asking for help from our readers and appreciate your help. Go to kagle.com/heroes. And hey, thank you for joining me today. And you will hopefully see this cartoon in your local newspaper. Thank you much, folks. And see you later. End the video.